Hey, Dale, how are you? Before my deer died last year. I don't know, it's crazy. I don't know what to do. I'm short supply. Why don't you hop on over to Little Big Ranch in Midkiff, Texas? Them folks are homegrown, and they'll take good care of your livestock needs. You sure? Oh, yeah. Some of the best known and exotic livestock that you could possibly ask for. Little Big Ranch, thanking God for the good land.
Leadership impacting in the American society.
They shine bright everywhere we go. Music for the people, making music for the people. They shine bright everywhere we go. They shine bright everywhere we go.
Leadership. Vivacious and flashing with excellence.
Where we go, they shine bright. Everywhere we go, everywhere we go. Music for the people, making music for the people.
Here is an inspirational view of the political, of the social political landscape with a James A. Hendrick School of Leadership.
Hello, everybody. Top of the day. Welcome to the James A. Hendrick School of Leadership. This is Jimmy. I just getting in the saddle for the Happy Warrior Rush Limbaugh used to be. I'm not saying that I in any way can fill the great one's shoes, but in some ways I can at least try. We're going to cover four news stories, okay? Kind of top of the day, variety of sources, because, well, quite frankly, you know, what's going on in the world? I'm in a bit of a miffed mood because of what's going on. So let's go to National Review first and see what we can find. Ooh, House Democrats, new leader doesn't believe in democracy. Well, here's the thing. We can take this and run this however we want. Dan McLaughlin, he says this, he says, a crucial value in a democracy, a system of government, in the acceptance of defeat under the under the rules of the system. Elections are held, and the winners are legitimately entitled to exercise the powers of their offices. Okay. Rule number one of news writing, okay? State clearly who it is that is in the leadership that says this. Well, here's a line here. Feminist Democrats have been campaigning against the legitimacy of our election since the aftermath of the 2000 elections. You know, to be honest with you, no crap. And I have to be honest with you. Some of you some of you Republicans calling this country a democracy, okay? I'm sorry. I'm picking at both parties because I just feel dang like it, okay? In fact, sometimes I feel like I don't want to cover too much of the political news because it can raise your dang blood pressure what's going on in D.C. right now. So let's go over to the Federalist. I'm low. Some of these stories I really don't feel like covering. Because really the top story is the issue of Kevin McCarthy. Okay, look, some of these people, 20 people, have nominated Jim Jordan. Okay, let me look this guy up. Because you have a Texas congressman, Chip Roy, who nominated Jordan. And I like what he had to say about, you know, debate and dialogue taking over on the House floor. And I mean, he seems to be a pretty solid man. He's an Ohio congressman. He's been in Congress since 2007. But other than he's for Donald Trump, what do we know about him? These people, Kevin McCarthy, Jim Jordan, that's what the Congress seems to be split about. Some saying Steve Scalise. Steve Scalise and Jim Jordan are supporting McCarthy. And I've heard said that some of these 20 are holding out for, you know, patronage thing. What kind of sham do we have? Pundits saying that what happened yesterday was draining the swamp. Going against the establishment. Okay, I'm anti-establishment, okay? I'd be suspicious of McCarthy, too. But when you have someone like former House Speaker Newt Gingrich supporting McCarthy, I mean, and then the two other candidates that people have floated around for Speaker supporting McCarthy, it's kind of like, what the hell? They're acting no better, I'm afraid, than two-year-olds. The Republicans at the get-go are acting no better than the Democrats. That's why I say what I say on my show. I am not a Democrat. I am not a Republican. I am a conservative Federalist nationally. Now, Texas, it's natural. I know which party I vote in Texas. Because, you know, Texans hold to the original intent of our founders, okay? Now, we're gonna go to CBN News because quite frankly, we need to cover some stories. Okay, here's one that's interesting. Fixing a broken system is ending cash bail. Is ending cash bail the answer? Okay, let's listen to this from CBN News.
While there are growing calls to reform the system, some say it pits the need for safety against the rights of the poor. In 2010, New York police arrested Khalif Browder for allegedly stealing a backpack in a Bronx neighborhood. Browder, 16 at the time, spent the next 3 years behind bars awaiting trial, a trial that never happened because Browder ended up taking his own life. His case points to a common problem for many who can't afford bond. Kate Trammell is vice president of advocacy at Prison Fellowship.
What we have right now is a system where too many people are in jail before they're convicted of an offense. I don't think you can say concretely from the numbers that everyone in jail is a criminal, and if they are awaiting trial in jail, then releasing them is dangerous.
According to a report by the U.S. Commission on Civil Rights, more than 60% of defendants are detained pre-trial because they can't afford to post bail. Those numbers have moved a number of states to take action, but courts have weighed in too. For example, on Saturday, the Illinois State Supreme Court halted a law that would have done away with the state's cash bail system.
Okay, so you get my drift. I hear some of these pundits, you know, and that are pro-Trump, and I am too. Don't get me wrong, I am pro-Trump. But they're talking about draining the swamp. What do we have here? Folks, we have an opposition defiant culture hell-bent on destroying this country. Okay, I want you to think about this. Is this republic worthy of the pursuit? Is it worth it? I want to ask each and every one of you. I can understand if people have an objection to McCarthy and they support Jordan and Scalise. Jordan and Scalise don't want to be speaker. They're endorsing McCarthy. No, I think this is petty political claptrap games. Okay? And if we don't stop this, if we don't stop this, I'm not sure how much of a country we're going to have left. Now, at the same time, though, one of the consolations that I have is that we know the time may come that the Constitution is going to hang on to the thread. But I think enough men in my church, and I'm hoping other churches, will rise up and say, hey, enough of this. Enough of this deceptive arguments, because we're not getting the patronage we want. We don't like the current spending bill and all that. It's okay to have dissent, but let's have some dang organized dissent. And we haven't had that in a while. And why? Because neither party can get their act together. A part of me doesn't want to continue what's going on here. But, as your happy warrior, I must carry on. I'm not saying that they absolutely have to support Kevin McCarthy. Let's find a formidable candidate, and you're not the party if you don't want McCarthy. Okay, look, I'm anti-establishment too. And I have every reason to be anti-establishment. You know what my anti-establishment reason is? I'm sick of crime. How about the rest of y'all? You sick of crime? Surely you are. Let's see if we can find this story from AMAC that's worth covering. Okay, here's a story by AMAC. The American, Mature American Coalition, I believe is what it's called. By John Grimaldi. He says this. Did we fall asleep last night and wake up this morning in another dimension? A surreal place where the authorities mock American ideals and tell us that the Founding Fathers had it all wrong, that we are not free to think, do what we believe is right, and follow our conscience. That ain't just about abortion. No, I'm afraid not. This affects the whole geopolitical and social political landscape of this country. COVID was the thing that disrupted the geopolitical landscape of this country. And I'm going to say this. I'm going to call it what it is. Because, we here in the James Hendrick Empowerment Network, we call it the devil virus, right? But I think it created a bigger devil virus. A more, not so much, you know, a physical illness. But more like a deep spiritual issue, an illness that has seeped into the political soul of this country. And no, we are not a democracy. We are meant to be, according to the Founding Fathers, a representative republic. Some of those who opposed McCarthy, I noticed that they were saying, you know, that we are a democratic republic. No, we are a representative republic. Okay? Samuel Adams, you know, his taxation without representation speech. Both parties, shame on you. I tell you guys, you know, I'm gonna be hard hitting. Now, if someone does the right thing, I'm gonna praise them for that. But if there's this contention over political patronage and positioning, I'm gonna be honest with you. It's gonna make me angry, and I feel like I and the rest of the American people have a right to be angry. Than telling our Congress, get your act together. Are you going to have the Democrats sweeping both houses of Congress and Democrats in 2024? Wake up, America. With that, I hope you enjoy listening to the James A. Hendrick School of Leadership. If you like what you hear, please subscribe and become a part of the James A. Hendrick School of Leadership classroom. This is Jimi Hendrick saying until next time, take care and be proactively informed. You guys carry on. Don't let your heart be troubled, okay? We just got one more day of covering the news, and then Fearless Faith Friday, my favorite part. Take care, you guys. And God bless each and every single one of you.